Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. And today we are going to discuss time conversion HackerRank problem. So in this problem we have given a time in 12 hour format and we have to convert it into a 24 hour time, which is a military time. So let's see the sample input, guys. Here you can see this is the input which we will get, and this is the output which we have to print because it's a 24 hour time. You can see 90. So guys, let's see, first try to understand what are the things we need to take care when we are trying to convert from 12 hour time to 24 hour time. Let's start. So guys, here these are the conditions which we have to take care when we are converting time from 12 hours to 24 hours. If the hour stands from 0 to 12 and it's AM, or if hour is from 0 to 12 and it's PM, because based on AM and PM it will change the time. One stands for day, one stands for night timing. And the similar way, we have third condition: if hours is equals to 12 and it's AM, it will have a different notation or representation in a 24 hour time. And if hour is equals to 12 and it's PM, then it have a different representation time. Let's see what it is one by one. So if we have hours from 0 to 12 in between and it's AM, then we can directly print it because there is no change. So whenever the input hour lies between 0 to 12, we can directly just print it. If it's AM, there is no change. The change starts after 12 hours. So the second, when we have hour from 0 to 12 but it's PM, so PM, then in that case we have to add 12 to the hours and print it because PM starts after 12 hours. So we are adding the 12 to the hour and printing it. In the third case, we have hour equals to 12, exact 12 here, and it's AM, then in 24 hour time we call it 00, and we have to make hours to 00 and we have to print it because we have just started, the day started from 00 to 24, and when hour is 12 and it's PM, then we have to make sure we are going to print it directly because you will never see 24. Guys, let me clear one thing over here. So if you have something from 0, so it will not go up to 24, it will be 23.59. whenever it reaches to 24, it will become 0. So that's why here in 24 hour time we have 00 whenever it's a midnight. At 12 o'clock sharp, we'll represent this via 00. Let's see this algorithm in action, guys. So we have given a function called time conversion, and here we are accepting one string s, which is the input time. So I've taken that string and splitting based on colon. For understanding purpose, let me note down the input from HackerRank platform here. So you can see, guys, we have this input with us. I'll take the same input while conversion. So I have taken the same example, guys, from the HackerRank platform. So now we are splitting this based on colon. So once we split this, so we'll get an array which will hold 7 0 5 3 element or string element this form. So if we take string of 0 and which will be represented by string, if we take string 0 it will be hours, you can see here, and the first element will be minute and the second element will be second. Guys, here we have to note second contains AM and PM also too. So that's why, so for getting the exact second, we are just calling substring function. So that start from 0 to second period dot length means the complete length minus 2, because we know AM and PM have only two letters. So we are subtracting that. So actually this is the second period, guys. From that we are extracting second and period. So 45 is the second and PM this is the period. So this is the second, this is the period which we are extracting from here. So after extracting all the stuff, we have wrote all the condition. So this is the first condition, guys, which we have discussed earlier. If the hours is between 0 to 12, or we can say if hours is greater than or equals to 0 and less than or equals to 12, and period, which is this, is equals to AM, then new time in string, we have taken one variable, in that we will hold the new time which will return finally. And so we have used some string dot format, guys. Why we have used this? Because we have to return the time. Suppose we have only one digit in hours, like 7 or 8. So we have to return 07, and here also we have to return 08. If it's a 12, already two digits are there, then we don't need to add 0. So time always have two digits. So that's why, to make sure it contains two digits, we are doing a formatting over here. So this is the syntax for that. We have, that's why we have mentioned 2 over here. It's 2D. So it will always make sure that it will return or print the string which is having a 2 digits. If you are not providing that, it will append 0 automatically. So hours we are representing in the 2D format. Then we are appending colon. Then we are printing minute. Then again we are appending colon. So guys, here we are not printing exactly, we are just appending all those string and storing inside the new time. So this is the second condition, guys. So in that again we are checking the same condition, but this time the period is equals to PM. As we have already discussed, if it's a PM, in that case we need to add 12 into hours. So we are adding 12 in hours. And why we are not formatting over here? Because we know if we are adding 12 to hours, so it means we are adding two digit to some digit, so it will always be two digit or more than that. So that's why we are not bothering about to add this, because it will always be greater than two digits. In the third condition, we are just checking whether hours is equals to 12 and the period is equals to AM. If it's AM and it's 12, it means it's a midnight. So we are hard coding hours to 00 colon and printing minute and seconds. And the fourth condition, if we have hours 12 and period is PM, so this time we are just assigning that to a new time in string. And once this is initialized properly, we are returning that from here. I hope, guys, this problem is clear to you. If not, please let me know in comments. I will clear your doubts. Let's try to run this example, guys. I'll just try to run in front of you. So the sample test case got passed. Now I'm trying to submit this code. Congratulations guys, every test case got passed. Guys, if you need the source code, you can just go through my repository and download the source code from there. The link is mentioned in the description box. If you have any kinds of feedback and doubts, you can mention the same in comments. I'll definitely reply over there. Guys, please don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe my YouTube channel. And for more updates, don't forget to press the bell icon too.